They see me rolling, they hate it.
Love them.
It's a quicker way of getting around the city when you don't have a car.
Have a bit of a gander and have a bit of fun at the same time.
Cheaper than paying for an Uber, and you get to see a lot.
All over.
As a pedestrian, I feel like there needs to be a lot more precautions and people need to be a lot more safe.
After a few drinks, that's probably when they cause a little bit more strife.
No, I haven't led one because at my age, it would not be very sensible.
E-scooters have been a controversial addition to our roads since they first reached our shores in 2018.
Sort of feel like a lion in the jungle.
A lion in the jungle, what do you mean?
Oh, just no predators. I'm just out here by myself on my scooter, just living life.
And it seems Australians haven't quite mastered the art of riding them safely. Alarming new stats showing scooter crash casualties are soaring.
Generally, those people are multiply injured. Brain injury, spine injury, chest injury, limb injury.
In Victoria, the state trauma centre's seen a doubling in emissions for e-scooter and e-bike-related injuries over the last year, and a quadrupling in the number of people needing intensive care. While police have attended 131 crashes involving e-scooters this year alone and issued almost 400 infringements to riders flouting the rules.
If you choose to hire one of these scooters, you need to know what the rules are. There really isn't any excuse for not complying with the regulations.
Trauma specialists across the country are calling for e-scooters and bikes to be banned or, at the very least, regulated.
Some personal responsibility whilst we're getting legislation into place, that's going to help alone. For every one person admitted with multi-trauma, it's life-changing for that one person and their loved ones.
Scooting enthusiasts, though, say a ban is over the top and that as a cost-effective, environmentally friendly and traffic congestion-busting mode of transport, e-scooters and bikes are here to stay. So how do we make them safer?
Well, Andrew Kirk has done a bunch of research into e-scooters for Queensland Motoring Group, RACQ. Andrew, how bad are we at riding these things?
Actually, pretty bad. Our survey results show that nearly 50% of riders have had an accident of some form or another, and of those, a high number needed some form of medical treatment. Another scary statistic was 20% of riders admitting riding under the influence of alcohol or drugs.
Is it responsible to have these things on the road, in your view?
Look, it is. We just need better rules and regulation and enforcement of those rules to protect riders and pedestrians and other motorists alike.
Andrew, we've got some vision here of a woman in Adelaide. I just randomly found this video. This is her here.
Yep. That looks familiar.
Yeah, she's familiar because it's Julie Goodwin. How would you rate her scooter technique?
Julie's done quite well. Look, she's doing all the right things. She's riding on the footpath. She's at a nice, safe speed. She's got her helmet on, good stance, nice and steady. The only thing I could say is maybe some more safety equipment, some gloves or knee pads or elbow pads, that sort of thing. But she's done pretty well.
And 10 out of 10 in the fashion stakes too, just quite for Julie. But, Andrew, it's clear that there does need to be some regulation here. What do you think governments need to do to make these scooters safer?
Rules, enforcement of the rules, better regulation, slowing down around pedestrians, and even to the point of getting the scooters off the footpaths and into bike lanes on lower speed roads would help.
Can I ask, though, when it comes to the specifics of that, given that you said there's a pretty high proportion of people that say they've done it drunk, do we need to be breath testing, like doing random breath testing of people on scooters? Is that what you're talking about?
Absolutely. Yes, absolutely. And those same rules and regulations for driving under the influence apply to people on scooters, so you can be caught and fined. Get more police and visibility out there on the streets to, you know, do some random tests and checking of the riders.
Andrew, is there a way to make people look cooler when they ride them? I'm asking for a friend.
Yeah, absolutely. Safety gear is really cool. You know, get your helmets, your gloves, your knee pads, your elbow pads, and if you want to go really wild, just get them in some bright, funky colours.
Polka dot overalls, for example. Andrew, yeah. Thanks very much for your time tonight. We really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.